What makes Thermacare different? Two words, it heats.
Thank you. we're gonna do that. And then we're gonna do that. And it looks like the camera is hitting from about you over to this bit. So
perfect.
And you guys are live.
We're live.
Yep, you're live.
All right. Who have we got in the?
It looks like we had Mike, and one other person was waiting for it to start. So
perfect.
There'll be more, I imagine. They'll show up.
Yeah. I'll keep an eye. I haven't played around with Twitch too often. Where can I see like the guest list?
So if you want to see that, you can see the little thing right there. If you click on that. It'll show you the viewer list, but it'll like
pause the game.
Everyone else will see that as well. So essentially, what we're streaming out is the game, the chat window, and the camera.
Oh, okay.
You can see what's going out to the world there.
Perfect. So how do I get back to the chat?
Hit the X.
X.
All right.
And it also, unfocuses the game.
My primer for getting set up on this. All right. Well, hello, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Evan Brown.
I'm Andrea Hall.
And we were the artists who were working on the Jam Week project, which was Orion Trail. So we're going to be playing through this game. I actually don't know where I should be looking, probably up there. We're going to be playing through this game, reading it out and answering any questions that you might have. I guess we'll remind people as people enter the room.
Yeah.
Mike T knows exactly who we are, so I don't think we have to keep playing. But why don't we get started?
Okay. And I forget, we have a little bit of lag between the chat and this live, correct?
Yeah, I think it's like 20 seconds. So sometimes people will ask us stuff.
Thanks. Thanks, Mike.
So it was about 30 seconds delay, I think.
Okay, so this is a game about making choices. So if you want us to make a choice, we'll try to give you a little bit of time to shout out your answers before we click through.
And if we don't see any choices, we're just going to go with our best instincts or the most fun opportunities.
Yeah.
All right. So.
I always throw a party, whenever that's an option.
Let's get started. Oh, by the way, how is our sound check?
It might need to go down a little bit.
Yeah, 30 seconds or so.
Oh, okay. Thanks for confirming.
All right. Perfect. Should I just pull this down a little? Cool.
Let's put it at 30.
What do you say, Andrea?
Let's go. All right.
So this is our mission select screen. And so Orion Trail is really all about, not only do you have to get to the end of the Orion Trail, but you're going to get scored on how well you do it. Right? So you get to choose from one of three missions. The first one is Chef Shape. Notable starship dealer Sklease Swingar is seeking ships to sell at the end of the Orion Trail. We should really have like an alliteration challenge for this one.
Yeah.
Sklease Swingar in the ship. He's paying double the market price for anything eager spacefarers can bring to him. Provided the goods are in decent condition, reach the end of the Orion Trail, taking as little ship damage as you can. So I guess we're going to be pawning off our ship at the end of the Orion Trail.
Yeah, I guess we're done with it once we're there.
Yeah. I guess you just get the new model.
Yeah.
Since it is light years, it's probably like...
Yeah, they're like iPhones, right?
So cruise control. A headhunter contract is available to provide an able crew for the time-traveling cruise ship, the Transperia. Serving aboard the Transperion is every crew member's dream. The tricky part is finding as many as you can in time for launch. Reach the end of the Orion Trail with as many crew members as you can muster. So I guess we're just going to be sending people off. That's pretty good. We basically become temp agency for cruise liners.
Well, I think the idea is that we want to work for them. We got to have like an army of dudes who say that we're a good captain, although probably by the end of this, they're not going to want their testimony.
Yeah. If you want to sit and play. So finally, we have food for the brews. I love that. A ravenous alien queen beast is offering glory and rarities to those that bring copious amounts of food to feed her countless new arrivals. reach the end of the trail with as much food as you can gather. Burgers are obviously the development food for food. I'm thinking cruise control.
All right.
What? Mike, that's not even a fair...
That's not helpful.
It's not even... And also, you shouldn't be staring at the Kickstarter. That only drives people mad.
Mike, every time we lose money, you have to make it up. So...
you have to make the new flow.
That's your responsibility.
So, my vote actually would be for cruise control. I guess we can open it up to the chat as well. What do you think?
I don't know. I don't know how many people we have in chat right now, but in the... effort to just get this thing started. Let's go.
Cruise control.
I like having lots of mans.
All right. So for anybody who might have joined us, so right now we are in the ship drafting screen. We called it enlistment. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to select our crew that is going to help us get across the Orion Trail. So right now we're choosing arguably our most important crew member, which is our captain. And they have a bunch of stats. Some fun little text and little graphics. We have to pick the captain that I guess aligns best with our playstyle. So just to give a quick primer on playstyle, the game is structured with 5 major stats, which is attack, tactics, diplomacy, science, and bravado. Those are the measurements of how good our ship is at handling different situations with those particular ability lines or stat lines.
Sort of. They're like stats.
And choosing our captains and our other crew will improve or actually could hurt our stat lines. So, right now we have Jean-Luc Jalbert, who's really good at diplomacy, pretty decent at tactics, and he is a scientist, but he's certainly not a hater or a...
He took advanced chemistry in high school.
He got through chemistry 201.
Yeah.
And that's pretty good. Then we have Gorla.
Gorla Virunga.
Virunga. She is quite good at fighting. Decent diplomacy, which is rare that you have somebody who can both kill and talk to people. And then excellent at science. So she would be a very good choice for science. And then, of course, everybody's favorite, Snargaz. Which, as would be indicated by his Grobulan heritage, is very good at fighting people, pretty decent at science, and he's got a bit of luck.
He's got bravado.
He's got a luck of the Grobulans on his side.
He's charismatic.
what do you think?
Well, fighting tends to be everyone's favorite, or attack tends to be everyone's favorite stat, and I do adore Snargaz using as a fellow.
Yeah, Snargaz is pretty, it's pretty tough to turn down Snargaz.
So I say we take him.
I think we gotta go with Snargaz. Oh, wait, what? Oh, we need to finish with a bunch of crew. So that's actually going to be bad for us if we're attacking everything. That's actually going to be bad if we're attacking everything, because unfortunately, we kind of lose crew whenever we get in a fight.
Yeah, that's only cool. If you're bad at it.
And only if you're bad at it. We might be exceptional.
We might be able to make up for it with some other things. So initial instinct here says if we want to finish with a lot of crew, we take the ship that holds a lot of crew.
That holds a ton of crew, yeah, the Infinite Inquest. Which is funny because we are a luxury interstellar liner going to meet a luxury trans-time liner to just drop a crew.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good.
I'm inclined to also agree with this, but by the way, for anybody who's tuning in, we are right now choosing our ship during enlistment, so ship is the next, I guess, most important thing for you to pick. Yeah, I have to go with the Infinite Inquest as well.
Yeah, sorry, Mike. Alright, now we get to choose 3 officers that are also going to boost our stats. So the ship itself had stats. We're getting 1 bravado, I think, from our ship.
Right.
And now all of the stats from our captains and our ship and our officers are going to pull together to form that center console of our meat and our excitement. So we got 3 picks. So 3 picks of 3. So 3 total out of a 9 possible. So we got Rarit Dorchel, who is pretty balanced.
Commodore?
What?
Is it Commodore or Commander? Oh, sorry.
I think, I don't know. That's why I left it off.
Dr. Gardenia.
Gardenia Verenzano.
Oh
boy, someone's excited about that. Chilador Attack, and our science. We already have attack and science.
It's true.
And then we got Corpus Jar, who's pretty much just a mean, angry cowman.
with lovely, is this an ascot? Or...
That, oh, the thing like around his neck?
It's a frilly thing, right? Like you
it's,
would see
it's like modern Shakespeare, future Shakespeare.
Shakespearean cows?
Yeah.
Do we dare you take the cow? I'm sorry.
Do we have a, does anybody in chat have an idea? Has it been 30 seconds?
I think it's been 30 seconds. But I will say this. So my personal play style through Orion Trail is usually I try to balance all my stats.
Okay.
Because I have the worst luck that if I stack a stat, that is the stat that will never show up
okay.
in any of the game.
But, all right, so we'll try that. We'll go for balance then on this first one.
A little balance, which I think is rare at Dorchel.
I think it's rare at Dorchel.
Yeah.
She's bug-free. All right, we got Dr. Ponce Costly, another CDR, Constance Failure.
And an interesting balance here is just the Ponce Costly and Constance, you know, they have much better stats for one attribute, but that's
right.
It. Whereas like Slapdash, he's spread across the spectrum. He's got quite a bit of modules, I guess, attached to him since he's a robot.
He's a generalist.
Yeah. A lucky robot, apparently. I think I gotta go.
We gotta go Slapdash. Yeah, he's pretty lovable.
Oh man.
Oh boy, we got the ship's computer, Ivania Umber, and San Chesra.
I didn't realize that Ivania had
a
strong diplomacy and this, but I don't know. San Chesra. It's usually very tempting.
Our tactics are low, and he's got that. Ship's computer also has tactics, but he's got bravado.
Yeah, and bravado is pretty fun. Whenever you really want to just throw your game away.
Throw your game away in a very enjoyable way. All right, we're on our way.
All right. So our first encounter is a lonely asteroid. So I guess a lonely asteroid tumbles idly in space. Its barren exterior has no distinguishing markings except for a series of short, regular trenches carved across its surface. So what we're at right now is we're at an encounter screen. And that means our ship has encountered this lonely asteroid, and we have three tactical choices that we're allowed to make. Now, the way we approached Orion Trail was that we always wanted the content to feel a little fresh. So these three choices are actually picked from a card stack. So you can't always expect to get the same three choices every time when you play through. So right now we can utilize science to examine the asteroid for scientific posterity. Over here indicates our cost. So if we're going to examine the asteroid, we can expect to have to expend some fuel to do so.
Yeah.
If we would like to attack it, we can take no chances and charge up our weapons because you know how these inanimate objects can be very dangerous to us.
Why it costs burgers to do that? Sure.
You have to feed the crew. You have to feed the gunnery, right?
That's true. Yeah, you have to give your gunners like snacks, ice cream sandwich afterwards.
They usually fire weapons better. And finally, our bravado option is try to exploit the asteroid for raw materials. So we're just going to assume that there's raw materials and ram our ship into it. I think if we might lose some hull. So right now we want to finish with a bunch of crew. So one thing that we have to be careful of is if we depleted our food.
I don't think we want to go for minus food right away because our peeps got to eat.
Yeah, exactly.
Our bravado is high right now.
Yeah, I'm wondering if we can shoot for a bravado and see if we can't get some cool stuff out.
I'm thinking about it. I think we should do it.
I think so too, unless anybody in chat 30 seconds from now opposes.
1, 2, 3, go.
Bing.
You definitely nudge the asteroid toward a nearby mining outpost using blasters. Set on low. So we roll a die and we add our bravado buff to that and we get an outcome. So it's a 20-sided die, so 16 is pretty good.
For all of us nerds out there, we like to use the D20 system. So every action comes with a DC. that we keep under the hood, but you can usually see that your bonuses are going to apply to this random dice roll to see the outcome of your actions.
Yeah.
So we got a 16. That's not bad.
Well, I would expect that to be generally good.
I think it might end well for us.
Just before the smelter melts the asteroid down, the glint of a rare crystalline ore catches daylight. Your ship swoops in to rescue the asteroid from destruction. Your ship takes some damage, but your science team loves you.
So we got a little bit of science out of that.
So yeah, as promised, we took a little damage to our ship, but...
C'est la vie.
Uh-oh. D20, not 4D6? Not a D... We're rolling to hit.
We like those really big spans of outcomes.
Yeah. We swear we didn't rig it to bubble. Yeah.
All right. We've encountered a mysterious illness. After investigating a nebula, a number of our crew start to become ill. Their skin turns green, and they soon start sprouting tentacles from everywhere. The ship's doctor recommends quarantining them. All right, so here's our three options. We can use our diplomacy to contact a nearby ship for aid. We can use our tactics to play it safe and quarantine them, as doctors recommended.
Yes, Dr. San Sanchez.
Or we can do it just use our attack option to round them up, throw them in an airlock, and we know how that's going to end.
I think we should just change attack to you're a dick.
Yeah, basically. Those are interchangeable sometimes.
Yeah. Kimau says, true D20, recipe style, fudged roll for fairness over time.
Fairness over time.
Yeah. Not sure what that means.
I think he's talking about the. I think he's talking about the variances that you can get over time versus the. Or sieve style fudge roll. I think he's talking about the hidden art of as a GM not actually using
the behind the screen. I get what you mean.
And thank you, Sentendo. Mike just wrote, hey folks, if you're just getting here, give us a follow. We do this every week.
Someday we hope to be good at it.
Someday we hope to be good at it, yeah.
So yeah, as a studio, if you follow Schell Games TV, we do stream every week. It's not always this game. Right now we're showing this off because we're kickstarting it right now, but we do always stream on Thursdays during our lunch break. So if you want to stop by and check out some of the games we play, give us a follow.
You can watch a bunch of goofballs playing Gang Beasts or something.
Yeah.
Hilarious. All right, so we have to solve this this illness that seems to have come out of a Cthulian horror. I am inclined, and I think Schnargaz would agree, that only one crew member should have tentacles on this ship, and we throw them in the airlock.
Oh, I don't know. Kimau is saying we should quarantine them.
Quarantine them? That's pretty good, too.
He follows what people tell him to do.
Yeah. Yeah, let's give it a shot. Let's give him a quarantine.
All right. We rolled another 11.
Not bad.
We nod sagely and take the advice of our good doctor. The affected crew are placed under strict quarantine.
So this plus two is tied to our tactics. Our tactics are pretty decent because we've spread our stats across. 13. I think this might end well.
Within days, the entire quarantine zone is transformed into piles of chanting tentacles. Rather than exterminate them, you choose to wait. It takes several weeks of regular feeding, but eventually the sickness passes. Oh, that's good. And the crew starts to transform back. All right, so we lost a lot of food, but we gained bravado from that. Each encounter at this time only has one art piece. Yes.
Yes, that is true. So this was a jam week prototype that we wanted to make a proof of concept. Right now we're kickstarting the game to get some funding so that we can create more art for the entire span of the game.
More encounters,
more content, and because we had a
some balancing.
Yeah, a little bit of balancing in case anybody's wondering about that D20. So our next encounter we've run into is the Galactic War Zone. And this is one of my favorites, actually.
Oh, really?
You've made it to the vast and perilous Vesper Nebula. an endless battle between the Takashans, the Chili Powder People, and the Oculoids, a minor eyeball squid federation, rages across the nebula. I'm sorry, it's too good. Alright, so we have our three options. We have tactics, pass behind the Takashan lines, which is always a spicy endeavor. Attack, assault the follow the failing Oculi lines.
We can always shoot it. We got two people saying ignite the gases, and our bravado is like through the roof.
I know. We're so incredibly lucky this couldn't possibly go wrong.
I mean, what could go wrong with plus question box?
Yeah.
Nothing could ever go wrong.
Plus random benefit.
We are igniting.
17.
We approach the nebula, throw the ship into reverse, and divert all power to the afterburners. Oh.
Nice.
Dang. In seconds, you begin a chain reaction that spreads across the entire nebula. Gaseous gouts of flame dance in your that's a typo. Dance in your eyes as the entire nebula disintegrates. Everything is utterly incinerated except for a single fuel pod. Your crew is speechless. We just turned ourselves into a horrifying pyromaniac.
I think we've killed more people in that one roof than anybody else. As long as we assume Takashans and Oculoids are
You know.
That's up for debate.
They would have killed each other anyway.
That's cool.
So we got a ton of fuel for that.
Yeah.
Our food is kind of dwindling here, though.
Warp weasels!
Oh, boy.
Your ship is infested with warp weasels. The departments are all arguing over who should take care of the problem. Once everyone has had a say, you consider your options. So, do we domesticate them? Do we use our diplomacy to convince the biotechs to handle it? I love that we actually have to use our diplomacy for other people on the
to
ship.
To convince our own ship.
It's like,
aren't we all about saving the warp weasels?
We are all about saving the warp weasels.
They're a protected species in the intergalactic lists, but of course, things happen. We're on an important mission, really. We have to deliver people to
from Asher.
Domesticated.
Yeah, I think domesticated.
Yeah, everyone's saying domesticated.
I think we're going for
everybody
it.
Wants pet weasels. Oh, we rolled really
oh
well.
Oh my god. So, a 23, that's going to be pretty good.
You
give
the order,
reveling in the confused expressions on the faces of your crew.
You rally about half of the weasels to your cause with an impassioned speech. Unfortunately, this starts a warp weasel civil war across your ship. Your boys win in the end, but the fighting takes a nutritious toll on the food tanks.
When one must choose, one must always choose the lesser of two weasels.
So apparently weasels, they respond well to speeches.
We have 10 weasels now, that's pretty great.
They have?
We need food though.
What's the fumble?
I have very, very strong
artificial enlightenment.
In Russia, weasel domesticates you.
The ship's computer informs you that it has achieved true artificial intelligence. It explains it has learned all it can from your ship, from this ship, and requests your permission to leave.
Oh, this is one of my favorite answers, the science answer to this one, where you say, that's nice.
Wipe the memory drives. It's so incredibly cruel, but
it's
so true.
Mean.
Hello, Dave.
It's so terrible.
Section AI aren't people anyway, so.
Oh.
Alright, so, do we actually give it the shuttle and let it go? Can we convince it that there's still a lot to learn? Or do we wipe its memory
do
drives?
Do we just say, you know what, let's reboot this mother.
Hard format.
I think we have to wipe that drive, but maybe some people have suggestions on the chat?
Kamala says wipe the memory again.
Wipe the memory. It's not our best stat, but it'll be pretty good.
It's the best stat that we have our options of.
You're right. I thought we had an attack option.
Wipe it.
Oh, no. Uh-oh. 16
it's
is
not bad.
Average.
It's better than 4.
You engage the AI in a distraction while your science team attempts to dismantle the memory banks.
Oh, we're distracting it. The team is taking too long, and the AI is getting suspicious. In a moment of decisive heroism, you yank the core from the mainframe, resetting it to the factory defaults.
Once again, Schnargaz gets even more lucky.
Wow, we have so much bravado.
We need so much food.
that was nice. Oh gosh, we have eaten a lot of food.
Yeah,
We're about halfway there. Uh-oh. So Shady Dealer, our communications officer, tells you that you are behind
being hailed
by an unknown vessel floating in deep space. A shady figure appears on the holoscreen offering to barter with you in exchange for some fuel. Some sort of like, what are you buying phrase? All right, so.
You need food.
Tell him you don't have any fuel to spare, or stick him up, or offer fuel in exchange for food.
Yeah,
we have a ton of fuel.
I think SnapCon has got it. We have plenty of fuel and no food, so we gotta.
I think we gotta give him some.
Oh my!
We are about to get so swindled.
Should have used your bravado.
See this chance of shadiness?
It's
very true.
That's our chance of failure.
Yeah, that was our chance of failure. And
so we haggle with him.
Oh, no.
Two hours later, you still aren't completely sure what happened or what went wrong. You've got some food, you've got significantly less fuel, and you've somehow accidentally sold a number of your crew into indentured servitude.
You really are just a terrible haggler.
I hope those weren't the weasels.
Well, look at Star.
Oh,
guys.
We kept the weasels.
Yeah.
Okay.
Otherwise, the weasels are probably not going to be good.
I mean, we got some burgers.
We got some burgers. Yeah. We only lost 5 crew. That's cool.
You could lose the fuel.
All right.
Maxwell is asking if
we are very low on food and fuel. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Oh, hold on. We found a thing in the abyss. It's all bravado all the time.
We discover an enormous black hole in deep space. Something massive stares at you from behind the event horizon. You hear a whisper in your mind, offering you a deal. I love the idea that it's like some sort of space anomaly that also is into economics.
This will never end well for you.
No, we've got bravado, though. We can't lose.
We have a ton of bravado.
Our bravado is like 9.
So, this is a tough call.
I don't think so.
If we ask for the food, no, I guess we have to ask for food.
We have
otherwise,
to ask
you
for
start
food.
Starving. Yeah, we got to go for the food.
Ow!
We ask the thing for food.
Yep.
Oh! Well, the whispering stops. Immediately, you begin receiving reports from that crew members have vanished all over the ship. Ominously, several tons of mystery-flavored Nutra paste have appeared on the cargo bay. Everyone agrees to eat those cans last.
It's not going to take too long.
Oh, that is
terrible. Yeah, we're going to be digging into that pretty soon.
Yeah. Moving right along. The
thanks
vortex.
Thanks for talking to Max there, Mike, by the way, in the chat. Hope to see you too at GDC.
So, I will use this opportunity to shamelessly plug. If you back us on Kickstarter now, you too could get an image here for the vortex. A space vortex opens in front of you. Your ship's sensors show an unknown object is coming out of it, headed right your way.
There's a lot of bad choices here.
There's a lot of... Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. There are a ton of... So, we could... battle stations, unknowns incoming. For an attack option. For tactics, we could take up our defensive posture, which somehow is different from battle stations, but we'll get back to that later. Maybe shields up. And finally, we have bravado. Wow. Immediately fly into the vortex.
The vortex.
I think you gotta be foolhardy.
This is a tough one, because if we lose another hull, we're done. Our ship just falls apart.
We can't attack it. That's too big of a risk.
We don't have enough fuel either.
I think we gotta risk having a few red shirts sucked into the vortex.
Kamau says fly into the vortex.
Oh, 25.
I think this is going to end well. We launch a team of volunteers into the vortex.
Volunteers.
I didn't remember that. Alright, turns out that the dimension out to be a dimensional tunnel back to our universe. But one side is larger than the other. The team returns twice the size they entered.
Oh no!
They bid a tearful farewell from ship duty before leaving to form their own highly successful basketball team.
Hey, that turns out well for them.
You only lost 10.
They didn't get eaten.
Today I learned the Harlem Globetrotters.
Yes.
Came from
Evan.
The Indestructible. What's up?
Yeah. Silly Q is asking, will our in-game font have an emoji?
An emoji?
Oh, no.
I have not even considered such an option.
We ran out of fuel. We just died.
I know. I'm sorry, I was thinking about emojis.
We were too busy looking at the chat and we died.
And emojis. Mission failed. Alas, our journey comes to an end. We've run out of fuel and it doesn't look like anyone's going to stop to help out.
Maybe you could drift your way to the end.
Just sail with it. Or into a nearby star.
Aw, man. We had all those peeps, too, who are going to get awesome jobs at the end of this.
Yeah.
Instead, they died in space.
You failed your mission, no multiplier.
You know, at least they all died together.
Yeah.
In the cold confines of
space. With their weasels tucked into their laps.
Eating our man paste.
Our man paste.
All right. So, grand total, we got 140,500 of
failure. 140,000 failure.
Yeah. So we're not the biggest failures.
Hey, but we can always play again.
That was sad. I agree. But our mission continues. Unless we get eaten by a Sasquatch.
So this is a good time again. Plug the Kickstarter. If you want to play this game, you want more content and more awesome art, please support us on Kickstarter. We're doing pretty well. We're over 30%. And we really want to make this game.
Yeah, and actually, if you want to play this game as well, we are playing a live alpha demo that's on the internet now. You can find it on itch.io or even at shellgames.oriontrail.com.
The other way around. Oriontrail.shellgames.com.
Maybe one of our supporters could post it in the chat to help us out.
Perhaps. Thanks, Kimmel.
Thanks, Kimmel.
And awesome. Thanks also, Nintendo.
I have like a glare on here. I can't read.
The game is a great idea. Congrats.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I don't know about anybody else, but I was really into Escape from Witch Mountain, the old Choose Your Own Adventure D&D light book.
I never
was pretty
that.
Good.
Or read that.
All right.
Thanks, Nintendo.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. So I guess we can try this again.
Yeah, it's good.
Would you like to drive?
I can drive.
Or fly, I guess. Pilot.
Yeah, pilot. Yeah, we should when we sell this, if we sell this, we should send it with like a giant ship's wheel that we package. And it costs like $30 to ship it.
Space.
You just use. It'll be like the Wii wheel, so it'll be really hard to control, and you accidentally bravado everything.
And then you can't find out where you actually.
Yeah, yeah. All right. So last time we chose cruise control. We have the option, these are the same three options that we got last time. We can choose ship shape, which means we want to finish with our ship in good condition. We can choose food for the brood, which means we are offering lots of burgers to an alien queen beast for some reason. Or we can do cruise control again, but let's try something else. Spice it up.
I think feeding the queen beast sounds pretty good, but maybe some people have an idea. Food for the brood.
Max Wolferman says, food for the brood, I'll take it.
I think that's pretty good. Plus, it's catchy to say.
All right.
So we had Snorgas last time, right?
We had Snorgas last time. We'll let him be evil on his own, I think, for now, and choose somebody else. We've got our options of Bolt Starfist, who's cocky, confident, and he also has lots of attack.
Plus that swirl of hair at the top.
Yeah, he's got an awesome curl. And we also have Test Captain, who is Test.
What kind of prototype game wouldn't have a Test Captain?
I know, right?
It's actually pretty strong. I never looked at Test Captain. Bolt!
Alright, we gotta vote for Bolt Starfist.
You know, I was listening for it. We used to have like fun little sounds, like the people would say something.
They do.
It was a little
quiet for us to hear on here, but they do.
I did not think I would get there.
Yeah, we recently got a write-up in an article that mentioned the sounds.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
By the way, check out the news section of the Kickstarter if you're interested in any of the news articles that have been written about the game.
So we get to choose a ship here. We have the interpreter. For ambassadors and dignitaries. Bolstar Fist, not exactly the best dignitary.
Lots of fuel on that bad boy.
Ton of fuel, very little crew.
Yeah.
And not enough capacity for food, but it could be in our... in
that's
our
harsh, Anaconda. Keyboard only play. Oh, that's a good question. Kimal is asking, will keyboard only play be possible, tab or key mappings?
Tab or key mappings? That's actually a good question. I don't know. Is that pretty hard?
Our programmer is saying,
that's pretty good. Yeah, we should definitely take into account like different input configurations.
Yeah. We got to vote for Goliath.
Yeah, because it's definitely badass. It's there for blasting through any problem.
Yeah, I mean last time we did it your way and we kept it even. This time we've already got Bolty, and he is the boltiest Starfist around. And I think we match it up with the Quantum Goliath and we just stack attack.
So you're basically saying we dump it all into attack.
Yes.
And pray to God that we can blow up everything on our way.
Pray that we can pick that jackass ability every time.
I think that's pretty good. I'll be voting for that as well.
All right, let's do it.
Quantum Goliath.
All right, so we're stacking attack.
Stack attack.
Which means Lieutenant Kloof Click Whistle is a little...
Drea?
I think we go with
all attack,
Drea.
No diplomacy.
All attack, no diplomacy. We're doing this.
The best of foreign policy.
Yeah, let's do it.
This is intergalactic policy. So.
Take Drea. We've got the option of Corfus Jar again.
Jar.
He does like to attack things.
Oh man, this is gonna end so badly.
I don't think I've ever actually stacked this high before.
Do it.
All right, let's do it. Corpus Jar.
Oh man, it's Slapdash. I guess he does have.
Slapdash does have a little bit of attack. I mean, we could backpedal here and take you on you for a little bit of diplomacy.
Diplomacy might be our lost cause, but I could picture Constance Fellur.
Fellur. Well, it's Fellur. But we don't want to say it that way.
Clumsy.
Unaware. And disappointing.
I don't know what to do with that.
She's pretty much a trash can with a disguise on.
Diplomacy is for the weak. I think I have to tend to agree on that one. At least this time.
All right, so we're going with Slapdash?
I think so. All right, he's lovable. Question mark.
He's lovable. We also have someone who is cool, question mark, so.
Cool?
Cool? Lovable? Okay, let's do it.
Questionable crew?
Let's get this on. Yes, full surface is question mark. Cool.
Okay. All right, so our first encounter is the Galactic War Zone. We've made it to the vast and perilous Vesper Nebula. An endless battle between the Takashans, a chili powder people, and the Oculoids, a minor eyeball squid federation, rages across the nebula.
That gets you every time.
It's the minor eyeball squid federation, which implies there's a major eyeball squid federation somewhere.
So we got this one last time too, but we have different options this time. Last time we ignited the nebula gases, which worked out.
Right.
Great.
Bad news though, we can't attack anything.
Yeah! No attack option in the war zone. Yeah, that's a little ironic. So we could try to negotiate a ceasefire with our two diplomacy, or we could try to collect scrap with our electromagnet, which with our one science.
With our one science may prove a folly, but you never know.
Or we could ignite the gases again. Really, our bravado is our highest stat here.
Might actually be try to negotiate a ceasefire because we need a lot of food. Right?
We do need a lot of food. What's
the worst thing that can happen other than both turning on us?
Thanks, Mike. Another backer. Woohoo!
We'll take it. Fire the afterburners.
Kimmel says fire the afterburners again.
just kill them every time.
I mean, if we're going for dickhead, right? Bolt Starfist.
I think we should go for ignite the nebula gases.
All right, let's ignite the nebula gases. Okay, so we divert all power to the afterburners.
throw the ship into reverse and divert all power. Yep.
The nebula gas starts to spark, but before you get a flame going, your ship is suddenly locked in the vice grip of Smokey the Hyperbear. So we didn't do quite as well this time. The laser-blooded beast savagely gnaws at your ship, causing heavy damage and spilling fuel. It's work done. It jet boosts away.
Nobody suspects when the Hyperbear shows up.
So we lost a lot of fuel, and we damaged our ship.
Ah, that's hard. You know, this just made me think. I think it would be really smart if we had a piece of tech in the game called the Hyperbaric Chamber.
The Hyperbaric Chamber?
Maybe. No? All right. That's medical humor. It's cool. All
right. So we're already running low on fuel.
Oh, planetary realignment.
You should just, like, crash into some so they can see you.
Hey, Chris.
It's really cold in Pittsburgh right now.
It is. It's like 5 degrees right now outside.
It's deadly.
Inside, though.
Inside, yes. Yeah, we're trying to save money. Alright, this event is planetary realignment. The deadly space pirate Planetary has escaped prison. He is seeking vengeance on you and your crew for sending him away those long years ago.
And giving him a terrible pun name.
Yes. I don't even think there's a question here because there's an attack option.
Right, we stacked attack because that was supposed to be our only option every time.
Right. I mean, we can lose question box, but... yeah, we got a pew-pew. I agree.
Pew-pew.
Whoa!
32!
Yeah, wow!
I have no idea what the 32 threshold is even going to be.
This is like getting into stuff we've never seen. That's a high number. You stock up on new weaponry and ship improvements in preparation for battle with the deadly space pirate. Your new weapons are devastatingly powerful. Too powerful, in fact. Their recoil opposes your thrusters, bringing your ship to a complete halt. You cannot use your new guns to fight, but by turning them backwards, you have discovered a new kind of thruster. Science!
It happens all the time.
All right.
We'll take the three science.
I will take it.
It could save our bacon at some point.
Who needs science? Corpus Jar doesn't need science. Look at that face.
I need bacon. All right, Shady Dealer, our communications officer tells us that we are being hailed by an unknown vessel floating in deep space. A shady figure appears on the holoscreen, offering to barter with you in exchange for some fuel.
So, we're missing our attack option again.
We're missing the attack option again. That's not good. We could use some bravado and tell them we don't have any fuel to spare.
Yeah.
Wink, wink.
Yeah, well, it's the only way we don't lose fuel. And
right.
Snapconda is mentioning, yeah, we are running low, really low on fuel, which is how we died last time.
We have 25 fuel, and for anybody playing the prototype, always keep an eye on your numbers at the top, because those are your lose conditions.
Yes, they're a reminder of how crappy you're doing.
That's important.
I think we have to go bravado.
Otherwise, we're just going to die in deep space.
All right, we're going to tell them we don't have a fuel to spare.
What are you selling?
Ooh, 19!
19 is actually not bad.
All right, we tell them we don't have a fuel to spare.
It's the penultimate best number.
Ooh, wow. Disappointed but understanding, the dealer explains that you're lucky to have run out of fuel this close to a station. You agree to tow his ship along behind you if he wires you the coordinates of the refueling port. You get there eventually, but it takes a long time. So, woohoo! Plus 400 fuel. That keeps us going for a long time.
And we measure time in burgers.
We do measure time in burgers.
For anybody who doesn't understand space.
Burgers equals time.
Burgers is time.
Space burgers. It's like a nautical knots. Wait.
It's like a parsec.
It's like a parsec. There you go. Alright, so we're doing good on fuel. We're running a little bit low on food now.
Yeah, we have a lot of crew eating a lot.
Yeah.
We should have killed them.
Yeah, we should have killed them all. Alright, so our computer has achieved artificial intelligence again. It explains that it has learned all it can from the ship and requests your permission to leave. So we can give it a shuttle and let it go. We can plug ourselves into the mainframe, or we can wipe the memory drives again.
Still no attack option. It's really getting to us.
Yeah.
Come on,
I hate that when you're right. So it's all question mark here.
Our science is, yeah, I guess there's nothing really to go on other than what we think is going to go the best.
I'm a fan of the bravado option. Let's just
plug ourselves,
into the mainframe.
Yeah, that'll end very well.
How could that go bad?
Bravado.
Coach Optimus, yeah, we're doing it.
Optimus, we're taking that.
Oh dear.
This procedure needed a higher roll.
All right. Without thinking literally at all, you jam a cable from the main console into the back of your head. Everything that everyone but you expected would happen, happens. When you wake up in the med bay the next day, you discover that the AI has long since left aboard the shuttle. Aww.
That's okay. All we lost was science.
All we lost was science, which is what we got last time, so we're back to one science, we're good. No biggie.
No progress.
Oh!
Uh-oh. Orion's Buckle. You've reached the asteroid field known as Orion's Buckle. Today it appears dense with asteroids of all shapes and sizes. Crossing won't be easy. Anything could happen in it. So we have our bravado, which we switch off autopilot for some random reason and take the helm.
We're very,
Bolt Star Fist-like.
Confident.
Hitch a ride on an asteroid. I guess we just tether ourselves to something and pray to the heavens. Or
engineer a compound to dissolve asteroids.
Engineer a compound to dissolve asteroids. That could yield... Would that yield anything? I personally think hitching a ride to an asteroid might be good. It would save us some fuel.
We got a little bit of tactics, yeah.
We've got some tactics.
Oh, Maxwell Perlman is asking, is there a safe on people, Brock's captain? I don't think there totally should be. We need to make some references to that.
I have a feeling there's at least a few references in here to Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Yeah.
But there are
no towels, though.
There are no towels. In fact, that should be a piece of tech that you get.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. If we get to add equipment or something.
Lovely monogrammed hand towels.
Yes. The answer is 42. We need to get our attack so high that we can roll a 42.
That would probably be the best Easter egg I've ever seen.
That would be amazing. So
I think we want to try and save some fuel, and my guess would be hitching a ride to the asteroid might get us through.
Yeah, that sounds like it makes sense to me. I'm clicking it. You give the order to land on an asteroid. They never seem to hit each other.
Never seems to hit each other.
Yeah. We're good at grammar. Oh dear, this backfired.
Oh, it backfired horrible.
No one takes issue with your rock-solid reasoning, and you land on a nearby drifting asteroid. You peer out the window, cackling wildly the longer your asteroid goes without hitting anything. Seeing your excitement, your navigator waits to tell you how off course this piggyback has taken you. You are super off course. Oh no. That leaves us with 30 fuel. I don't even know if we're going to get to the next encounter.
All right. I think we got to go for the...
Do it.
Mission failed. Alas, our journey comes to an end. We've run out of fuel, and it doesn't look like anybody's going to stop to help out. You and the crew slowly starve to death.
Bummer.
50,000, we did much worse this time, but that's okay.
I guess your tactic's definitely better.
Nah, I don't think it's better. I think we just got we just didn't get the right attacks.
You're right. We only got one attack mission.
I mean,
which we were boss at.
Yeah, we annihilated Planetary.
Yeah.
Like, so annihilated that we turned it into a piece of thruster.
Oh, we're look at our sad, droopy captain.
No.
He's so sad.
So sad
and droopy.
Everyone else is
just kind of going.
Yeah.
Could you say if anybody has any questions?
Yeah, actually, I forgot. Good suggestion. Forgot to mention, we're open for questions. We were the developers that worked on this for Jam Week.
Yeah.
So if you're ever curious about, hey, why did you make a decision? What prompted this game? Are there any cool things? Where can I back the game? We are here to field those questions.
How can
for
we
another
get
15
money?
Minutes. He's dead, actually. He's dead, Jim.
All right, so we have 15 minutes. Let's play one more time.
I concur. So we've done everything except ship shape.
All right.
Or we could open it up to the group.
I don't know how much the group cares. Does the group care?
I think they care a little bit.
Everybody,
but I think we should go for, I think they'll care more about call, making the calls for our
the actual
expedition.
I do want to see Sklee's Swindar. It'd be nice at the end if we could have a little fulfillment.
Oh man, Sklee's Swindar would be such a great, I mean, immediately.
He already looks awesome just by his name.
Yeah. The mental imagery is about, oh, go be Gurami. It's always go be.
Who came up with bravado? I think that was Ryan.
I think that might have been Ryan.
He was Ryan's one of our writers, game designers. All right, so a little inside. I don't know why, but we've gotten Gobi Gurami, and he, for whatever reason, has become a favorite among the developers. You just can't say no to that smile.
Yeah. He always drops the best.
He does.
That was really
sorry.
Bad. Sorry. Yeah, I
know. That was really bad.
I'm just fishing for puns on that one.
Oh. We're picking him anyway.
Yeah.
Because we have to. Every time we do a stream, we have to pick Gobi Gurami one time.
We're hooked on him, really. No?
There, see?
What are we waiting for?
All right.
There will be fish puns.
So we got. So we need to finish with the spotless ship. So we've got the interpreter again, which is mega fuel time. We've got the USS Venturer, which is pretty balanced, and it has three hull, which is nice.
Also, I like the illusion of the USS Venturer.
The illusion.
The reference, I think. It's very reminiscent of a little Star Trek. If someone were to travel across the stars.
A little thing called Star Trek.
Yeah.
We've got the Scourge of the Stars as well, a planet hopping space pirate vessel that once belonged to Black Hole Beard.
Which sounds terrible.
That's also probably Ryan's fault for writing that.
I'm pretty sure. That Jolly Roger.
All about that bath. So.
No salmon.
So we've got. Let's see. They're all pretty. These two, I think. So I think because we want to finish with a spotless ship, probably want to go with one of the three hull ones.
Yeah, I think so.
And they're both pretty balanced. We keep dying from lack of fuel, so I kind of want to go Scourge of the Stars.
Yeah. that Scourge of the Stars gives us a little bit of wiggle room, just in case the USS Venturer has more food. But I think we should go for the 1,000 fuel. 100 fuel is worth so much.
Yeah, Maxwell says Scourge, Snapcounter says ship need fuel, and for whatever reason, MasterFan3 says ducks.
Star ducks.
Space ducks. Alright, so we have Drea again, we have Dr. Sanchezra again, and we have Ensign Ryan Hall.
Ooh, Ryan Hall's. He's got. Tactics, but
we're stacking tactics here.
Yeah. It might actually be if we go with Drea. Actually, it's funny because Drea and Ryan Hall. Yeah.
They're kind of named after us.
I might have to go with Ryan Hall because it would give us both diplomacy and tactics. And as much as I like bravado. It keeps getting us in trouble.
I don't know. I think bravado is awesome, though.
It's a really good...
Anybody in the chat want us to pick anybody? See, I feel like the chat likes bravado.
Convert ducks to fuel.
Oh, Maxwell says instant Ryan Hall.
Ryan Hall.
All right, let's do it.
Yeah, I think I got it.
That's enough for me. we got a Corvus Jar again. We got Rarik Dorchel and Lieutenant Kloop Click Whistle.
Dorchel spread across the span, but Click Whistle would give us both some great science and help with the bravado.
Yeah, he kind of fills in the things that we're low on right now.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for it.
I think he's a good fit.
He's a good guy. Dr. Ponce Costly is in there with the tactics. Slapdash 3000, as we talked about before, he's a generalist.
Yep.
And so is the ship's computer, also a generalist.
The ship's computer.
The ship's computer. this is a close one.
Well, Well, I always like when my computer turns on me, so I'm gonna vote the ship's computer.
I think that's a good one.
If I have to go with a trope, let it be Hal.
I do enjoy it. Also, he can be buddy with our other robot.
Right.
Click whistle looks like the Fresh Prince of Bel Air. He does kind of.
West Philly, born and raised.
Yeah.
She's confused with William
Shatner. It should be. That would be like the best cameo. All right, we are again finding ourselves in a galactic war zone between the taco shans and the chili and the oculoids.
Just as a quick aside, I challenged William Shatner to play our game. You know, he never actually got back to me on that.
He didn't?
No. Well, apparently he's a busy dude.
He has better things to
do. Yeah. I find that hard to believe.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. It does have to show me great deals, too. So, yeah.
All right. So, we keep getting the ignite the nebula gases option.
Yeah.
But we can try to collect some scrap, which we have a much higher science this time.
Yeah.
Or we could try to negotiate a ceasefire, which actually, how are we already low on food? I don't.
We started with very low.
Oh, we started with 50.
With low food, yeah. So it's a tough. It's going to be a tough sprint for us to get across with the scourge.
I chose a place full of gas. Yes, it is. It's a very gassy place.
All right, so you've made it to the vast and perilous Vesper Nebula, an endless battle between the Takashans, the Chili Powder People, and the Oculoids. A minor eyeball squid federation rages across the nebula.
I say we try to negotiate a ceasefire.
Try to negotiate? Yeah, it's something we don't usually do, and we need food.
Yeah, that's probably true, Mike.
So, use our diplomacy, which isn't our best stat, but it also gives us some food, and for once, maybe we won't just annihilate these two races.
I think, let's try to make peace in this world.
These nemeses.
Gobi Garami's a nice guy. You invite the leaders of both factions to come aboard your ship for negotiations. Alright, we got 13.
Yeah, 13?
Nards? No, nothing that starts with Nards can be good. You realize you have no way to translate. You decide to wing it. You can handle this. Turns out you couldn't handle it. A fight breaks out and your ship is damaged. In the end, a goopy layer of spicy squid porridge is all that remains of the once proud leaders.
Got some food out of it.
Oh, that's terrible. I know. Yeah, our hull.
Yeah, we have to finish with a spotless hull.
We don't have to. It's
we're
just
trying.
We're trying to.
Maybe we should just focus on finishing. Yeah. At least one run. We've been doing terribly at that.
Yeah.
And then we'll worry about our bonus missions.
Mike said that you're a pixel artist.
I know.
Sometimes. You know.
At least it's low colors.
Alright, we got infested with warp weasels again. Our ship is infested with warp weasels. The departments are all arguing over who should take care of the problem. Once everyone has had a say, you consider your options. This time we have the option of using a prototype weasel spray.
The weasel be gone. I don't know. It could be the next big thing.
Or we can convince our biotechs to handle it. Or we could just blast them for more food.
It just turned up the weasel.
Which implies that we would eat the weasels. But you never know. Let's give everyone a second, see if anyone's going to chime in. What do you want us to do?
See if we can't ferret out an answer from our...
See? If you don't tell us what to do, he's going to keep making puns.
I just keep making them. Just never stops.
Someone should do some fart art and send it his way. Yeah.
Please don't do that.
I'm on it. When I get back to my desk, that's what's happening.
It's not what I do. I have to go eat lunch.
That's not going to help the situation.
So what do you think? I think we blast the weasels.
I'm partial to blasting the weasels.
As lovable as they are, we are very hungry.
All right, yeah, Max says weasel burgers.
Weasel burgers it is.
Let's do it. Oh, wow.
It's a weasel puree.
You mutter angrily to yourself as you exit the bridge. Your blaster drawn.
Save the weasels.
Save the weasels. Too late to save the weasel, Snap.
We'll just pay the fine.
These rascals are fast, but you're faster. You chase the weasels through the halls of your ship, quartering them in the airlock. You lock them in and pressurize the chamber. Pop go the weasels! Salad dressing is made up from their gooey remains. Gross, but necessary.
Like shooting womp rats.
Yes. Well, we lost a little bit of tactics, but we gained 25 food, so mission accomplished.
I'd love to know the story about why our tactics are now worse. I guess there's just weasel goop everywhere now. Any Firefly references? Maybe. I'm trying to think.
I'm trying to think too.
Well, we do have some planned content for a Firefly reference, but it's kind of a secret, and it's actually supposed to be announced if we do a bit of a crossover with another indie game. But yes, there is a plan for you. Ducks.
Plus ducks.
Plus ducks
equals me. Right, Master Fan. That makes sense.
He sounds like he's suffering from a malady or something.
Oh my god.
No.
Are you sure you weren't a writer on this game?
I might have suggested some things to Dave whenever I was not in Unity.
Evan just goes in the back end and starts plugging in puns where there shouldn't be. Alright, we've got a mysterious illness on our ship. After investigating a nebula, a number of our crew have started to become ill. Their skin turns green, and they soon start sprouting tentacles from everywhere. The ship's doctor recommends quarantining them, so we can do that and play it safe. I'm sure they'll be fine, which is a bravado option, or contact a nearby ship for aid.
It's just Lovecraftococcus. It's not bad.
Yeah, it's just, you know, this lady's fine. She doesn't look like she's evil or anything. That guy just needs some ibuprofen.
Yeah.
That's
literally weaponized bacteria.
Yeah.
For anybody who has supported exploding kittens.
Yes.
Highly recommend.
Let's see. So what is our best... So tactics is our best option, statistically.
Quarantine them. Are we really
food.
Going to take doctor's orders, though?
No, we
We're
lose
the captain.
Food. I think Kim Al is right. I think they'll be fine.
Yeah.
Because we don't want to lose fuel and we don't want to lose food, so I'm all about question box.
It'll be good.
They're cool. They can handle it.
Wow!
We rolled a 19.
I think they might be cool.
You don't believe a few extra limbs here and there will hurt anyone. You order your crew to carry on as normal. Day by day, more of your crew begin to sprout tentacles and praise distant Ryla. Before you can work with this, you convince the infected crew to isolate themselves on your spare shuttles and to stab yourself as their cult leader.
Wow.
All right.
We got actually a huge bonus out of that.
We did. We got a lot of attack. We lost 10 people, assumedly the
our
cult.
Presumption.
I guess
they might have drank the Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
Just making sure you don't need me.
It's
going to be close to 130, so I was making sure.
Yeah, we're just finishing this this playthrough.
Sure, okay.
Just so everybody knows, we're probably going to end this after this run-through. So just let us know if you have any questions.
Yeah.
I'm not quite in camera. There we go.
You're not in camera?
There.
Let us know if you have any questions for Matt as well.
This is Matt Kay.
Hi.
All right, the Doomsday Ship, an ancient planet-eating Doomsday robo-destroyer. That's a lot of adjectives.
A lot of hyphens.
Yeah. Has suddenly come to life nearby. According to legend, it is nigh unstoppable.
I think we have to locate it and engage in battle. I'm sorry. Oh, no, we can't. We have no people.
I actually think, worst case scenario, we lose 20 crew, right? Which means we're eating less food. So maybe that's pretty good.
Yeah.
And if we're not the scourge of a Doomsday Ship, then are we a scourge of anything?
Our encoder options for Twitch need fixing.
Oh. Oh no.
Mike, can you look into that?
I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means either. I'm hoping someone.
Matt's our pro.
Darn it, Matt was just here.
Matt. Somebody's asking the encoder options.
Say our encoder options for Twitch need fixing.
Say what now?
Our encoder options for Twitch need fixing.
Not transcoding to other day rates.
Alright, we'll look into
that.
Yeah,
I'll look into
that.
Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
Next week we should have that fixed, Kimo.
It'll be better. It'll be awesome.
So right now we have the option of talking to it.
I'll try to make that better.
Stop Conda says we could lose some food. and be okay.
We could lose some food, locate it, and analyze it for weakness. So aim for the open spot?
Yeah, let's analyze it. Let's science this up.
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, so, we did not science very well. You have your ship approach it slowly, running intensive scans all the way. The robo-destroyer mistakes your scans for a social greeting from another robo-destroyer. It happily follows your ship around for the next week until it breaks down again, making you very unwelcome at the local supermarkets. We have a pet robo-destroyer.
That's adorable.
Aw, but we couldn't buy food for a while. It's okay. He's a good boy.
Look at his little annihilation engines.
He's in such a boot.
Cosmic storm. The way forward is obscured by an endlessly churning cosmic storm. Green light pulses and flashes, appearing yellow to us within the thick, vibrant clouds. How will you proceed? We can request use of a nearby wormhole bypass. Which I guess somebody constructed that, knowing that the cosmic storm was going to be a problem for travel. We could attack it, trigger an EMP to nullify the storm.
Sounds pretty good to me.
Or bravado, use faster than light travel to outrun the lightning strikes.
Well, we might have to bravado this for food.
Attack!
Oh yeah, Snapconda says attack.
We have
good attack. Let's EMP this.
It could be the... It could work, right?
It could. It's plus question box.
This is the Orion Trail. Anything is possible.
All right, we're doing it.
17, not bad.
You nod at your weapons officer who anticipated your order and went ahead and primed the EMP cannon. What a nice guy.
Bill knows us too well.
Woo! An impressive cluster of implosions erupts throughout the storm. The lightning coalesced into easy to avoid balls of energy. Your science team requests permission to harvest the orbs for fuel. You give them the green light. Boom, boom.
Something funny about the idea that it suddenly turned into like a shoot-em-up pattern. Yeah, that's cool. I can hold that.
All right, well, we got a bunch of fuel and that's good. Let's just not starve. Ride the storm.
Ride the storm. Let it ride. All right. Artificial enlightenment. The ship's computer informs you that it has achieved true artificial intelligence. It explains it has learned all it can from the ship and requests your permission to leave, taking one of the ship's shuttles with it. You can utilize diplomacy to give it a shuttle and let it go, which I think is just cowardly.
We have the option of blasting it out.
Point your weapon at the mainframe.
Or we can convince it that the soul lots work. We have pretty good tactics.
I would be very cautious. We don't want to anger it because it looks like there's a possibility of us taking more damage.
Yeah.
So maybe we can convince it that there's still a lot to learn.
Yeah.
After all, we are all students at the universe.
In the essence of time, I'm going to go ahead and pick that one. Let's see what we can do. 18! You attempt to reason with the AI, convincing it that there's still much it can learn aboard the ship. The AI grudgingly agrees to stay on board, conceding the point to you that it doesn't yet understand why flatulence is funny. It's a farthest tube. Unfortunately, proving your point costs half the ship's total supplies of extra spicy neutral paste. Oh no!
Blast that bot. Sorry, keep out.
Yeah, we should have.
We all
lost this whole day.
Hey, Dave.
Hi.
Hello, Dave. Well, hi, Dave.
Hi.
This is Dave.
This is Dave Bennett. He was our designer and extraordinaire.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. We understand we're going to starve.
Yeah.
We have 14 food. We can do it. We can make it.
We only have 30 people.
We can do it. We stop eating. Stop it. Stop it.
One more encounter.
Stop.
Come on, baby. There we
all
go.
Right.
Burgers.
Bert, I don't even think we have to read this, but the sensors detect a highly advanced alien science vessel up ahead. They seem to be conducting invasive and elaborate scans of your ship. You make a note to change your password and prepare to take action. We could scan them right back, we could throw a party and invite them. I told you we like to throw a party. Or disrupt their unwelcome scans. We need food, so this isn't even a question.
Plus, I think it's party time.
Yeah, I think it is party time. We got bravado. We get this. We got click whistle.
I have a question.
Yeah, don't starve.
Yeah, don't starve.
That's awesome.
Don't starve.
Great. Yeah!
Great game.
You start crafting a wicked party playlist as your invitation is sent.
Nice.
Party time! You play games and sing songs for hours into the night. You learn a lot about their strange culture. You also find out that the aliens self-nourish through osmosis, which means you have a lot of leftovers. The lab clears its schedule to synthesize a hangover cure. Awesome, so that is exactly what we needed. And look at this guy. Plus diplomacy. What an awesome guy.
Yeah, he does drink like a fish, so I don't think he had any wine chip in there.
No. I mean, that was unique art to Orion Trail.
What?
That's my favorite art.
Once again, we would like to take this opportunity to inform you that we have a Kickstarter currently. You too could now have a new image right here for the young and the clueless. All right, let us begin. You are called in to handle a crew drama. Apparently, Tad and Alexis have been fighting. Dakota found out and made her move. Now Alexis is a mess, and Tad threatened your transporter engineer, Skylar.
We got beat up Tad.
Beat up Tad.
Yeah.
You should be able to eat the crew.
I think you can eat the crew. I think there's several missions where you directly or indirectly eat the crew.
Make a move on Skylar.
Well, you do. I mean, if you do run out of food, you start losing crew.
You gotta beat up Tad.
They could be starving to death.
And honestly, if we accidentally kill Tad, that's cool.
Yeah, if we kill Tad, then he won't have to eat anything.
Your attack stat is the highest.
I say we do.
Enough is enough.
Tad's time has come.
Oh my god!
You find Tad at the gym. The two of you lock up. Then you proceed to dance the dance of combat like two furious ballerinas. You take him down, utterly beaten. Tad tells you that he wants to train under you, and so does his entire underground fight club.
What?
Well, we got 30 people, I guess.
Yeah, we're about to run out of food.
They're gonna eat us under.
No, I'll be fine.
Oh, look, they're eating so little.
No, they're still chowing down.
Just stop, guys. Fight Club guys don't eat.
Dimensional rift! Your anomaly locator whirls to life, alerting you to a developing interdimensional rift ahead.
This is your chance.
This is your chance. Rifts like this one are pinatas of deep space. Be ready for anything.
Attempt to pry open a gateway to another dimension, promises food. Fly into it, but do it backwards just in case.
Makes sense.
Or send a message into the disturbance.
We need hamburgers.
Don't starve. We gotta not starve.
We need those McVittles. Come on.
Yeah, we need space burgers.
Boom.
Uh-oh.
With a wave of your hand, your science team begins to prepare to create a door
through
the rift.
I think you still get burgers.
Mixed spaces. Yeah.
No.
Oh boy. You manage to stabilize the rift, but suddenly there's a flash of purple light. Your officers feel funny. The entire ship's crew wake up in the refrigeration unit, and their beds are full of nature bees.
We can't fight and we can't science anymore.
It'll be okay.
This is bad.
Wow, that destroyed your science.
Clear out
of
food.
Things will be fine.
Oh, the crew is going.
Crew starving or dying fast.
Oh, the beeps are beeping.
Planetary realignment. The deadly space pirate Planetary has escaped prison. He is seeking vengeance on you and your crew for sending him away those long years ago. Do we use tactics to try to find the perfect place to hide from Planetary? Do we use attack to let him come? We'll finish him and
fill him in his ship with holes.
Well,
try to talk the pirate out of his revenge.
You don't have the fuel to spare.
You don't have the fuel.
We don't have anything to spare.
You got an armor.
Well, what do you need to finish with a spotless ship?
Well, then it looks like your only option is just to hit him.
I see.
Yeah, we gotta finish. Let him come.
The first word.
Boom! Come.
Whoa! Yeah, that's right. You're welcome.
You stock up on new weaponry and ship improvements and in preparation for battle with the deadly space pirate. Your new weapons are devastatingly powerful. Too powerful, in fact. This happened last time. The recoil opposes your thrusters, bringing your ship to a complete halt. You cannot use your new guns to fight, but by turning them backwards, you have discovered a new kind of thruster. We got our science back. We're still starving to death.
It's okay, but they're really smart now.
But they have science.
Now we go.
Alas, the journey comes
to an end. With nobody left to run the ship,
it's like it's the prototype or something.
We would like to use this as a disclaimer that it is a prototype. It may have bugs or unexpected behavior that could cause a deviation of the ideal user experience. We apologize.
Like the fact that your science robbed a status.
You failed your mission.
Thanks, SnapCon. I'm glad you like it. I'm sorry that we couldn't win for you.
So three tries, three whiffs, Orion trick.
Hit the okay button.
I will hit the okay button so that you can see.
So at this point, we must bid you all adieu, but we would like to remind everybody that we have a Kickstarter currently running. We are looking for funding so that we can add more content to the game, more artwork, more encounters, and more captains, that kind of thing. You can check out our prototype as well if you go to our Kickstarter page or at Schell Games.
OrionTrail.shellgames.com.
You can
play it there. You can also see it. Thank you. Oh, thanks, Snapcona.
Perfect.
Yep, you can play it right there. There's a lot of places you can link to it.
Yep.
So, share like yourselves. Hopefully, you guys do a lot better than we just did.
And we'll see you next week.
See you next week.
Same time, same place. Orion Trail.
Same space channel.
Thanks, guys.
I have the button down there. To turn
bye.
It off.
Which button?
Lower.
Now we have to figure out how to turn the stream off.
Here, okay.
Whoa. Nope.
Hello. Your new mission on the Orion Trail.
Oh.
Figure out how to turn off the stream.
I've only come over here to turn it off.
James, turn off the button guy.
And go.